I'm going to go over the demo phase of our kitchen remodel. I wish I'd had a video camera back then and I could have videotaped everything, and that would have made this whole lot easier, but I didn't. What I did have was a regular still camera, and at the time I took a bunch of photographs, and I had a website that I put up with the photos and captions and explaining what was going on so that our family and friends could track the progress of our kitchen remodeling project. And that's what I'm going to show you here. I'm going to show you a bunch of stills from the project and explain what you're actually seeing in those photos. It was a lot of hard work. In the TV shows on HGTV and DIY, they talk about how much fun demo is. And don't get me wrong, it is fun smashing things. It's also really hard work, let me tell you, especially when you're a couple of old fogies like Noverblatz and I. But in the end, it was definitely worth it. It took us a long time. It took, depends on what you classify as demo, figure between two and a half weeks, thereabouts, to complete the demo phase. It took a little longer because we ran into problems with removing a wall. But, I mean, roughly about 2.5 weeks. It was really, really hard getting like the cabinets out. These days, kitchen cabinets are very modular and they're just screwed to the walls and they're fairly easy to remove if you were going to demo it. But for this house, these cabinets were, at least some of them were original to the house. So they were obviously custom built to go where they were, and they were extremely hard to remove. That was not an easy process. And the other big problem in this kitchen is that there were multitude of layers in different things. For instance, we removed part of the wall only to find a hidden backsplash that we didn't know was there. The floor had, I don't remember off the top of my head, let's see, it was one, two, I think three layers of flooring plus subfloor, and it was just, that was a nightmare. Part of the reason it took us so long is that we really didn't have the right tools to begin with on that floor. It would have been great if we had our air hammer or air chisel when we first started the floor instead of when we're almost done with the floor. Because removing that ceramic tile floor, imagine hand chisel doing that, backbreaking work. And there was other nightmares, like for instance, the walls of this kitchen weren't like modern day drywall. What they used to use back then was something else. It was panels that were like, I don't know, 16, 18 inches wide by, you know, 8 feet long, and they ran them horizontally. So you had multiple ones on the wall and they were real thick. And then on top of that was a bunch of plaster. And where the walls met the ceiling, they spanned that inner corner with wire. And then the wire ran up into the ceiling and down into the wall, you know. So as you were removing all of the plaster and the drywall up there, you had to go in with nips and cut each of those pieces of wire so that you didn't damage the ceiling. Tedious, very, very tedious. And we had a dumpster out in our driveway. That's where we were putting all of our debris. It was a mess. We tried our best to keep the dust as contained as possible, but there's only so much you can do, even with plastic all over the place. Anyway, here are the photos. Check them out. There's Noverblatz, and he's pointing to every electrician's nightmare, the hidden splice in the wall. Great. Now, you remember me telling you how hard these cabinets were to get off the wall? Look at how many nails were in these. It's no wonder it was difficult. And here's the hidden backsplash I mentioned. You can see the white texture that was on the wall that we knew of as a backsplash. Then there was this lovely sparkly stuff. The floors were an absolute nightmare. Our first day, we only got through three rows, as you can see, and that's the backer board that's showing instead. Here's a close-up of why it took so long to get these tiles up. In some cases, we had to literally pulverize them with a sledgehammer. They were not giving up. And people, remove your spacers when you're laying tile. We actually found they had left spacers embedded in the mortar underneath of the floor. Here's a shot that shows you that underneath of the concrete backer board was a layer of lovely vinyl tile, don't you think? This shot shows you most of the floor after we'd gotten all of the tile and backer board up. There's just a little vinyl still left behind. And here's the troublemaker that started it all. There's the lovely waste pipe that ran along in the toe kick of the base cabinets, disappearing down beneath the stove. I made the mistake of taking this shot after I'd swept, so there's dust all in the air. But if you look, you see the horizontal panels of the wallboard. Very strange. Now, this is a close-up of that wire that I told you was in the inside corners where the wall met the ceiling, also in the inside corners where the walls turned. And then for some reason, in some places, there was this different kind of mesh. It's kind of like what you'd see on a stucco wall. Don't quite know why it was there. It didn't make a lot of sense. And then this was a surprise. After we demoed the back wall of the little pantry closet, we found they had walled up a pocket door that used to be used to close off the kitchen. Looking down, what you're seeing is the pretty much useless pantry, and just above it, the useless coat closet. These are tiny spaces. They were ridiculous. I don't know whose idea this was. Those tiles you see are only 12 inches square, so not very big. Before we ordered the dumpster, we were just putting all the debris out on these tarps in our yard. Did a number on the grass, let me tell you. And this was one of the last shots. This is the kitchen after it had been totally demoed, and you'll notice that lone 2x4 there in the foreground. Well, that's temporarily supporting the wall after we removed it. Whoops, another problem, and I'll tell you all about it next week. Okay, that's the demo phase of our kitchen remodel. It was a lot of hard work, let me tell you, but in the end, definitely worth it, and you'll see that soon. Next week, we talk about construction. See you then. Bye.
See ya.